Whoa, it's Wulzy. Welcome back to another Geometry Dash building episode. I don't have any specific plans for this video. I don't really know what I'm going to do with the decoration in this part, but I know what I'm going to do with the transition at least. My first goal is to make this transition a bit smoother because as you can see, the outlines come in out of nowhere. I need to make them a bit more presented. Okay, so these outlines are on color 11, which I'm going to set to black blending initially. So I want to have a brief period where you slide out of the cube portal and these outlines are invisible. Then I want to turn them straight back on after that. Need to keep the blending ticked, but I can just change the fade time to 0.2 to white, just like that. I think that's going to be okay. So there's some glow here, but there's also a pulse here. I kind of want to make that glow invisible and turn it on with that pulse on that object. I feel like that will be quite smooth because without an object line, it kind of looks a bit weird. This is all on color 2 though, so I'm going to have to set these pieces of glow to new IDs, 227. We'll turn them off before the portal, so 227 with the alpha trigger like that. And then on the same line as this, on another 0.2, I can maybe fade them in. Or maybe when that first pulse hits, hold on, let me just align this with that pulse trigger up here. If I just selected something else, yep. I'm so clumsy. It's so scary sometimes trying to navigate the editor as an effect creator because you can just knock stuff around. I think this is going to work. Invisible. And then it fades on, just like that. Boom. I think I nailed that. To make it a little bit more smooth, I'm going to copy the values of these outlines, check where they need to go on these blocks, and just slip them onto here as well. I don't know. So I've got this block lined up with the outlines and the glow as well, and then I kind of want to go and copy the value of this overlay pulse thing that I made last time, and give these blocks the same thing, so when you slide into this cube section, ba-boom! It pulses right into the new block design. I think this is going to be pretty successful. Alright, have I been able to pull off the one-take transition with this? I don't know. I'm probably going to have to go back and change something, but let's see how it looks initially. I think I've nailed it. I think I've been quite smart and efficient right there. Awesome. Okay, so I have no idea what to do for the decoration in this part. I've added a couple more saws here and there, as you'll notice, but I just don't know what to put for air decoration, so while I think of ideas, I am going to polish the level a little bit, starting with the beginning transition. This should just be as easy as bish bash bosh. I'm going to give it a new group, which is 228. I'm also going to give it the moving group 3 of the very beginning. It's on T3, on pretty much maximum Z order, don't fade, don't enter. At the very beginning, it needs to move about 10 blocks to the left, just so it covers up the left-hand side of the screen. 228, there we go. Then right here it needs to fade out, so 228 is going to fade out to nothing. My eyes, I forgot to make it black. Oh, you get no chance to move whatsoever. I think I have the perfect method of doing this. I'm going to put some slopes right here on group 1 that just give the player a safety net down to the first block, and I'm going to show the player right here. And I'm going to hide the player at the very beginning. So you just kind of spawn in after you go through the first couple of saws. I think this is the only fair way there is of doing it. Except, bruh, maybe if I enable this little trail thing, you can at least see where you're going. I think that works, honestly. I think that's a pretty effective way of getting up. It's like you get beamed up into the level. I like that. That's pretty cool in my opinion. Alright, what layer of this overlay is the top? B2-5, B2-4. Okay, so this one is the top. I need something above B2 and minus 3. Okay. Alright, so I'm making a beam that is on B2-1 just for consistency. Don't fade, don't enter, blah blah blah. Now how many objects is this? 13. Alright, so it's 26 blocks long. I think that'll do. This needs to be group 229, and I've just thought of a better way to do this. I can just have this on the right hand side of the screen like so, and then I can also assign it to the moving group, which is 152. Boom. Then right as this part comes in, I can move the new group 229 in about 250 blocks to the left on an ease in, and we'll put one move time. Let's see if I've done this right. Wait, hold on. I've just thought of a better way to do this transition. If I turn the fade time up, that's going to be so smooth going in, right? Hell yeah! So it should move in around about now. Oh, you! Ruining the fun. Oh, well, it would help if I made it the right color. God damn. That's twice in a row that I've done that. Let's see. That's too fast. It's too fast. Well, okay, this is smooth, but it doesn't really go with the music how I want it to. And some of that is still showing up above. I don't know how to fix that. That pesky blending overlay. This is going to get added to group 230, and it's going to get turned off for this transition. So just at the same time as this movement, 230 is going to fade off for 3 seconds to 0. In fact, I want this move trigger to be in line with that dash orb, and I'm going to change the move time to 2, and then this alpha trigger can have exactly the same treatment. Let's see this. There we go, it just swipes off into darkness. That's exactly how I want it. Awesome. The overlay for the black glow is also getting turned off on the very right-hand side of this portal. I gave this a brand new group 231. Alright, so now this is polished. The first two parts are completely clean with transitions in and out, etc, etc. I love that intro now. It's so much more smooth to look at when I'm playtesting. This is pretty much the same. I still need to add decoration, but I like this transition out. The little black sweeping screen, and then everything turns off and you can see the gameplay clearly again. Awesome. I've just swapped the filler blocks for bricks, which copy the values of these slopes, and you'll see how it looks in normal mode right now. I do not know. I forgot about my intro thing. Jeez. That was drilled into my mind to fly up instantly. I do not know whether the bricks look better. I think they tie into the pulsing theme a bit better, but they could definitely be improved somehow, and I don't know how. I prefer them to the default blocks, so I think I'm gonna keep them for now, even though they look so ugly when they're like this in the editor. I'm doing something that should have been done a long time ago. I'm changing these 3D lines in the beginning ship to be half objects, like so. You'll see the reasoning behind this in a split second. Right, so what I'm doing is I'm making some black glow to cover the bottom of these blocks, the bases. Because I feel like the level is quite flat, the color of the waves is very similar to the base block. So using the biggest glow object, I'm going to make a staircase like so. This is all going to be on half opacity black, just so I can make a nice looking gradient that differentiates these objects from the wave. Need to make sure it's on B2 and minus 8, and then I can half space it and put it right against the edges like so. It's looking a bit more shady now, which is to my liking. It's a bit less flat. I think it ties in a lot better with the wave. Now it's time to make the effect in the ball part, maybe even the spider if I can extend it on for that long. Alright, first off I want to make the ground effect, so I'm going to be using these lines in the editor tab, the little chain thing. It's on group 233, it's going on T3, almost max, and it's also going to get a brand new group ID 234. Then it's getting copy-pasted, moved up one step, moved onto the next editor layer just for safety, and it's getting a brand new group 235 instead of 234. I think you can see where this is going. Okay, there's 5 lines now. Sweet. This is going to be set to color channel 1, which is white, and I'm not just going to copy-paste it and flip it on the top. Instead, once I tick the boundaries for this, I'm copying the top line and moving it up to the very edge of the top set, giving it another new group, 239, then it's getting moved down, 240, etc, etc. 233 is going to move as soon as the player gets to the portal, 9999 move time, lock to player X, then the lines are going to get turned on in this fashion once I turn them off initially. They're just getting turned on with no fade time at all, just a full opacity white. Then underneath this, on the same moving group 233, there's going to be a layer of black glow that's just below these lines. Anywhere on T3 will do. Brand new group for the bottom one, then I need to copy paste it, flip it onto the top, give this a brand new one. So while the bottom set of lines turn on, this new group, I think it's 244, I could be wrong, fades on. Then while the top group is going off, 245 is fading on. Then these are getting turned off with no fade time, just like that. So duh duh. And then right on the very edge of this alpha trigger, it's starting again. I forgot an important detail. These lines need to turn off as well. I only had them set to turn on. So now they're getting turned off. Let's have a look. I've set the background to purple just so I can see. This is almost smooth. I think when those black glow pieces fade out, it needs to be more incorporated instead of just going duh-duh at the end. So let's just cut this to one iteration so it's more clear to see what's going on. So I should move these triggers a little bit along so they align with this. Then I can take these and make them fade off at the same fade time, just back to zero like that maybe. And then the loop can go on based on this point right here where this current fade time ends. Boom! Nice, I think I nailed it. Now there's one thing I've forgotten about, and that is the spider portal. As you can see, when I tick this box, its range is bigger. There's more screen to cover. Ah, this is gonna be iffy. So the top set ends on this trigger. So I can move all of these triggers one block to the left so that that trigger is in line with the spider portal. Then I can select the top set and give this group 246, find the spider portal, then slide a move trigger in right above the portal, give it 246, and then we'll just move Y up 10 with no move time. Pretty much, I mean, it's as close as I'm gonna get. Then on B41, I'm gonna have just a base background that's on color 9. Nice. In fact, since color 9 has a pulse going into this, I'm using color 16 as a copy color 9 channel. I know it's lame, but it's how it is. While I'm at it, let's increase the brightness by, we're gonna say 0.14, because it's a cool number. I think this is a nice shade of purple to work with. Also, I extended it up to the ceiling right here as well. Boom. Then to cover this base, I want to have strips that increment like this with the same groups as the alpha triggers. These will be on B3, 1, don't fade, don't enter, and also 25% opacity black. And this just looks weird. I don't know. Maybe it's because there's no fade time on it. But let's tweak the color of that base down to like a plus 0.04. It needs to be barely visible. Then I want to have a circle in the middle of the screen. Maybe just to the right a little bit though. Moving group, brand new group. It's going to have B3 and 2. And this is going to be the same color as the background, but it's going to have plus 0.1 added to it. So similar to what the base originally was before I darkened it a little bit. Then I'm copy pasting it, shrinking it down to one scale, putting it on editor layer 15, just so I can distinguish between them. Then I'm adding plus 2 Z order, I think. So it looks like one circle. Good. In fact, why just have one circle? I could copy these circles in a row like this and just move them slightly to the left. So these have group 248. I'll set up the move trigger for that right now. Move 248 to the left about 400 maybe. I don't know. Easing out. We'll just say 15. So these circles should be moving towards me now. Nice. We're building up layers right now. But then I also have to move the circles up 5 so that they're in the center when they get to the spider. Oh my goodness, there's a lot to think about at the moment. I'm tweaking the colors once again. The circles are going up to 0.08 brightness. And this should be enough for me to do the mask that I want to do in this part. Oh boy. Alright, so here is an arrow that I plan to move in between the two layers of the circle. It's on B3 and 3. These groups, so 233 is the moving group, 249 is a unique one for the arrows, and 250 I've applied to the circles and also this little overlay thing so that they can all move up at once at this spider portal. I need to remake that move trigger now, which I will. 250 is moving the object 5 up for 2 seconds, easing out. Then I need to copy this arrow, go in the next editor layer, next Z order up. To do this, I had to move the center of the circles one up the Z order, so that's on 5 now to make room for the 25% opacity black. So I'm making the groups of the overlay to this arrow identical to the ones in the background, so it looks like nothing is passing through the circles, but they still get smaller. So now these arrows need to be moved. Group 249. They're getting moved about 800 blocks to the right, easing out, yada yada, 15 seconds. I've got the toggle on as well. Well, the arrows are going through, but it just looks dink. It looks so bad. Oh my god. Okay, so the arrows are in sync with the darkening alpha thing on top of the base, even when it moves up, which is nice to see. The issue is, it just looks bad, so I'm gonna have to replace the insides of these circles with something else to make it a bit more impressive. Okay, so let's get a line right here, rotate it, half space it so it goes right into the center, paste the values of what the insides were, and that fills up the middle from end to end. Nice. So then we can just copy this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I just need to shrink these lines up a little bit to match the edges of the circle. Okay. I'm going to roll with this, I think. Alright, I think that's it for this episode. I still need to tweak colours and polish stuff with this, transitioning in and out, etc. But I'm happy with it for now. I've done what I wanted to do, and I think I can't take any more because I'm just so burnt out. I'll play from zero. I've spent so many hours today trying to fix this, and man, I was losing my mind because I just couldn't get it to look good. I kept on setting wrong groups to things and stuff was going wrong. You've seen the best bits, honestly. I've been recording for hours and you're getting like a 10-minute video. I don't even know if this is 10 minutes. This could be like 20 minutes. Oh, okay, well, thank you for watching this building video. Check the links in the description. You'll find the handle to Mystic, my new channel artist who made my profile picture and banner. You'll find my Instagram, my Twitter, my Discord. Leave a like and subscribe, and have a good day. That's still drilled into my brain, even if I am absolutely knackered. Jeez.